When I was 16, my mother, she had a stroke, and she's fairly young. My mom's in her early 40s, and so at the time, she was in her 30s. And I remember going to the hospital, and I was so hesitant. I didn't want to see her that way because I didn't know what she was going to look like. Well, as soon as I walk in, I was like, wow, she looked the same, with the exception of the only thing was her hand. Her hand is, she struggles with it now, her left hand. But I remember it was so, she didn't want it to be about her even when I was there, and she was joking around still, and I was just so amazed at how it just didn't seem to change anything about her. And to this day, she even jokes. She refers to this hand as her little hand. And I'm like, Mom, that's not funny. She's like, well, it is. She's like, but it can still kick your butt. I'm like, oh, okay. So, you know, that's, I always remember that, you know.
I bet we've been together for a million years.
And I bet we'll be together for a million more.
Oh, it's like I started breathing on the night we kissed.
And I can't remember what I ever did before. What would we do, baby, without us? What would we do, baby?
Actually, when we first started dating, I was working at an advertising agency, and I worked on a movie account, MGM UA. And I would take her to these screenings, the opening nights, Friday night, opening night, walk the red carpet, and I'm thinking, I'm scoring serious points. And she's just like, whatever, who's that, you know? And I'm like, that's Claire Danes, Leonardo DiCaprio, don't you know that, you know, and she could care less, really. I can really count on this person, you know, she's the best one to take care of Ethan, and she's the only one that could do that, really. And so that really gave me that assurance of, I don't have to ever worry, as long as, you know, she's there, everything will be fine.
Yeah, if there's one word that describes a mom, it would have to be self-sacrifice. She spent all of her time, day and night, cooking, taking us to places, dropping us off, picking us up. I remember she would always used to say that I would never know her love. I would never know the extent of her love for me. Even when you have kids, you'll never really know, because you yourself will never be a mom. You'll never have experienced everything, all the joy that I've experienced in raising you, in bearing you, in being your mom. And I'm older now, and I'm almost afraid, but at the same time happy to say that I probably will never know the extent of my mom's love for me.
There was one afternoon where it was in the fall time, and the trees had all turned red. The leaves were really, really pretty. And she took me out of the car. We were walking on the sidewalk, and she started picking up leaves. And as she was picking them up, she made them into a little bouquet. And she gave that to me. And for some reason, when I think about my mom, I think about that afternoon and that bouquet of leaves.
Maybe the world.
She's very muscular. She likes... 40. Sometimes she's strict, or, you know, mean. Not mean, but, you know, a little. Well, whenever I'm feeling, I guess, sad about anything, she always notices, like, right away. I'm usually, like, nothing, you know. I'm trying to get her off my back, but she keeps on, you know, asking me about it, and then eventually you talk about it, and then she'll find me ice cream or something nice like that. But she takes me out a lot, actually. Yeah. She'll try to take me out of school so we can go snowboarding. So, yeah, we have fun together, and I don't know, I don't say thanks enough, I guess. So, yeah, I love you.
This one particular Monday morning, get to work just dreading the week ahead, you know, typical Monday blues, and just not looking forward to kind of the work and the week and the commute and more than anything, I was really just, with the amount of hours that I was working, I was just really missing my family. I get to work, I sit down at my desk, unzip the briefcase and pull out my laptop and open it up, and sitting on the keyboard is a picture of Angie and Dylan with a post-it note on it that said, Dad, we love you and we miss you, Mom and Dylan. And at that moment, there couldn't have been a more perfect remedy for all that I was feeling and all that, you know, all the stress and anxiety and with the new job and everything. And there just couldn't have been a more perfect gift at that moment for me. And, you know, for her to kind of think of that, you know, with all that she had been going through and, you know, with trying to manage and raise Dylan kind of on her own. I mean, she couldn't have come up with a more perfect gift, and albeit a very simple gift, but it's something that I'm going to remember for a lifetime.
Today, I just wanted to wish you a very happy Mother's Day. Hopefully everything will go smoothly, and that I love you very much.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
And I'll also say something for Ethan in Ethan's voice.
I love you, Amma. I'll always love you.